Hello, welcome to the class of HTML5 programming. So today we will discuss about the CSS3 flexible box layout. So how to add this flexible box layout in HTML program. So here the purpose to add this flex box in the HTML program is to provide the flexible layout to the web page. So here the first of all we have to configure a flex container to add this flexible box in the flexible box layout in the programs. So here this flex container will be configured by using this .fc class, and we have to declare the properties in the declaration part of this class selector. So here I have used this class with the name fc, and in declaration part I have used these different property to define these different flex properties. So first of all, this flex container indicates the element that will be contained in the flexible area. So here this class will be declared here in this division structural element, that is class equals to fc. So now let's see the different properties that are defined here in the declaration part of this class. So first property is the display property. So here this display property is used to configure the flex container. So the value of this display property will be flex or inline flex. So first of all, let's run this program and see how it will be displayed in the browser. So go to run and click in launch in Chrome. So it will be displayed like this in the browser. So here the display property is equal to flex. So as you will change the value here to inline flex, now save the program and refresh the browser. So it will display like this in the browser. So as you will resize the browser, it will display the bold division structure element that we have defined in the body section of the program. So if you will write here the flex value, now save the program and refresh the browser. So now you can see that it display this whole part, the whole division structure element in this browser viewport. So as you will reduce the size of the browser, it will also reduce the size of this different structure element that we have added here. So this is the about the display property, and the value of this display property will be flex or inline flex. After that we will discuss about the flex direction property. So here I added the flex direction property. So the value, so the here this flex direction property is used to configure the direction of the flex items. So here the value of this flex direction property will be equals to row, column, row reverse or column reverse. So let's see how it will be displayed in the browser. Like here I have write the row. So now save it and refresh the browser. So it will display the same image like as it is displaying here. So if you will write here the another value, that is column, and now save the program and refresh it. So it will display these different boxes in this way, in the vertical direction. After that, the next value is the row reverse. So as you will save the program and now refresh it. So it will reverse the value of this row. So as it is starting from here, but now it will start from the end. The next value is the column reverse. Now save it and refresh it. So it will start from here, starting from the 7 from the top and ending with 1 at the end. So in this way we can display these different boxes like in this way in the browser. So now save it and refresh it. The another value that we are going to discuss is the flex wrap property. So here this flex wrap property is used to configure the flex item to be displayed on a multiple lines. So as here the value of the Lex wrap will be no wrap or equals to the wrap. So here the no wrap configures is used to configure for a single line display, whereas wrap will allow the flex item to be displayed on the multiple lines. So as you can see that here we have configured the no wrap. So if you will write here the wrap only and save it and refresh it, so it will display like this in the browser. So it will wrap itself to be displayed in the browser. So as you will reduce the size, it will wrap like this in the browser viewport. So right here no wrap. So these are the two values associated with the flex wrap property. After that we are going to discuss about the another property, that is flex flow property. So this flex flow property is used to configure the set both the flex direction and flex wrap properties together. So here the value for this flex flow property will be row wrap. Now save it and refresh the browser. So it will row wrap the particular box layout in the browser. So this particular property, that is flex flow property, will be used to set the flex direction and the flex wrap property together. So now remove it and refresh it. So these are the different property that are associated with this flexible box layout, that is display property, flex direction property, flex flow property and the flex wrap property. So the other properties which are configured with this flexible box layout, we will discuss about that properties in next class. So this is all about how to configure the CSS3 flexible box layout in HTML. Thank you.